Good morning, friends. Welcome to Shekhar Pre-Market Roundup. First, in the global markets, yesterday when we closed, most of the European markets are trading almost flattish, and by the end of the day, all the European markets closed in mix, with certain markets being green and the rest being flat to negative. The American markets also closed almost flattish yesterday, with Nasdaq being down by just one point, as it is approaching a psychological level of 5,000 on Nasdaq. Yesterday there were statements by Janet Yellen that they will be keeping the interest rates stable at the current level. Still, they don't find inflation stabilizing at around 2%, which is the target rate, and they won't take any decisions hastily on interest rate front. Coming to our markets yesterday, there was a lot of volatility ahead of the expiry today, and at one point of time, Nifty, which was up by around 70-75 points, finally ended the day with a gain of modest 5 points, that is just managed to close in green. Yesterday there was a FIIs were buyer around 516 crore in cash market segment, where DIIs were buyer around 19 crore rupees in cash market, whereas FIIs were seller around 900 crore rupees in index futures, which is a little bit of worry sign, but it is just because of the expiry which is supposed to be there. Today we expect some volatility in markets because of expiry and delivery budget. Mostly we are expecting that market will be in a range of around 35 to 40 points on the lower side and around 50 to 60 points on the higher side for the day, given there are two important events, that is railway budget and expiry also. Now let's have an update on derivatives.
Good morning, friends. Let's have a view on derivatives. From past couple of trading sessions, we have seen that markets are continuously trading very volatile ahead of major events lined up, like February series, FLO expiry, railway budget, then union budget. In yesterday's trade also, we have seen that Nifty started the session on a positive note, and initial number of trades it was trading in a narrow range, but in last 1 hour of trade started falling from 8830 levels to 8750 odd levels, as selling was seen in many of the blue chip counters like Tata Steel, BHEL, Sun Pharma, due to which Nifty ended the session at 8767 levels with a loss of 0.07%. In this period, we have seen that short positions were built up by market players, as open interest is increased by 3.86% from 2 crore 83 lakhs to 2 crore 94 lakhs, and Nifty futures price decreased by approximately 5 rupees. Cost of carry also decreased by 101.78% from 23.33% to minus 0.42%. PCR is increased 1.15% from 0.87 to 0.88, which is clearly indicating that put option has seen good build-up. In yesterday's trade, we have seen that put option has added around 15 lakh shares in open interest, whereas call option has added around 10 lakh shares in open interest. India VIX was down by 3.57% and finally settled at 20.78%. In the options activity, we have seen that 8,900 call option has reduced marginal number of shares in open interest. Approximately 0.65% shares were reduced, and 8,800 call option has added 13.44% shares in open interest. In the put option side, we have seen that 8,800 put option has reduced 5% shares in open interest, and that activity was shifted to 8,700 put option. It has added approximately 11.73% in percent shares in open interest. That means people are shifting their positions from higher strike price to lower strike price. It may act as a negative sign for the market. On bank period front, there are two securities. One is HDI and second is Unitech. And yesterday, FIIs were net sellers of 1,292 odd crores in future and options segment. They were net sellers of 931.10 crores in DEX futures. They were net sellers of 753.60 crore in DEX options. They were net buyers of 385.62 crore in stock futures, and they were net buyers of 6.69 crore in stock options. Our 5-day CVM stands at 8810. Lower range for the market would be 8700, and higher range would be 8810. Singapore Nifty is currently down by 4 points, which is at 8816.25. It is a March future, and being an expiry day today, and also all eyes on railway budget, we may see huge intraday rickshaws in today's trade. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now let's have a look at some trading ideas for the day. The first idea being the power companies. Delhi government has decided to slash power tariffs by around 50% for 400 units consumption per month. Action to be taken is short Reliance Infra and short Tata Power. Astral Microwave, second idea. Government has cleared 22 of 29 proposals from defense manufacturing sector. Action to be taken is long Astral Micro at 150 with a stop loss of 147 for a target of 155 and 158. We have railway budget today, which is an important event to watch out for the day. Tata Tele Services ASL can't bid for new airways now, and they also cannot top up existing holdings. This is by the telecom department. Airtel is looking to sell some stake in Bharti Infratel at 3-6% discount to market price, as per a media report. TVS Sri Chakra is looking to expand capacity of 23 lakh tyres a month. Dalmia Bharat has increased its stake to 74.6% from 48% in OCL India. Chambal Fertilizer is voluntarily winding up its overseas subsidiary Cayman Islands. JK Tyres hopes to complete capacity expansion at Chennai plant by mid-2015. Silstrip Wheels has received an order from Renault Brazil worth €5.8 million, that is around 41 crore rupees, for supply of 7.6 lakh wheels. Dr. Reddy Labs has received an US notice seeking information on drug pricing mechanism. This can be sentimentally negative for the stock. Penal Industries subsidiary Penal Engineering Engineered Building Systems and Penal Enviro Bags bagged an order of 150 crore rupees across divisions. SNM announces partnership with Lupin Pharmaceuticals, and Ratan Tata has confirmed JLR's US production. On the stocks with positive bias on derivatives basis are Wockhardt Pharma, Bharti Airtel and Sesa Sterlite. Stocks with negative bias are Tata Steel, Bank of India and M&M Finance. We have expiry today in derivatives, so there can be a lot of action seen in derivatives segment. These are some of the stocks where positive and negative biases are there. Stocks for investment are Aditya Birla Nuvo, Ultratech, LIC Housing Finance, M&M and Larsen. That's all from our side, friends. Thanks and bye. Have a nice trading session.